guys, I just still can't believe I'm at the gravestone of Hattie McDaniel. This is history. Like, this is history. Good morning, everybody. Wherever you are, this is my view. So I'm in still Los Angeles, California, and we are off to visit Hattie McDaniel's grave. If you guys don't know Hattie McDaniel, do your research. She was she broke grounds of history. She was the first nominated African-American to win an Oscar. So, we're definitely gonna pay our respects. And y'all look at the waves, isn't that nice? I see the waves. I don't know if y'all can see them, but I can see them. But we are on our way to pay some respects to her. And we're gonna pick up maybe some flowers. I haven't really thought that through yet. So that's basically about it for right now. But look at these waves. You guys see these waves? Very, very, very nice. I feel like I hadn't made a video like this in like a long time. Like, I'm trying to get back into it, so y'all gotta bear with me. So, I mean, it does feel good to get back into video making videos and vlogging and all that good stuff. It does take some time, especially if you are working on several projects like me. So, yeah. Grand Theft Auto 5, but this feels exactly like Grand Theft Auto 5, just a little tiny little bit, because you see the incline, they call it California incline, and you also see the buildings in the back. Like, yeah, I feel like I'm on that gang for some straight. So I think that we're gonna, like, so far so good. Like, we ran into no traffic and nothing, so that's pretty good. There's a lot of traffic in that direction over there, but hopefully it ain't a lot of traffic we going at. Ain't nobody got time for all of that. I love driving when there is no traffic. This is kind of strange to believe in Los Angeles, because it's normally traffic. It's traffic in the other lanes, though. My lane ain't no traffic, so I ain't gonna jinx it. But yeah, we're about, like, I think 14 miles or something away. Maybe it's 14 minutes away from where we're going to. So we're gonna, just gonna scope out the area first, and then we're gonna probably come back and put some flowers on there on a grave. And I think that's that. I really want to do something else though, something cool today. Like, just what I normally do anyway, like ride around and stuff. But I feel like I want to do something else, you know, something interesting, you know. Just want to show you guys the skyline of Los Angeles. Not that we're probably gonna be stopping here anyway. Just thought I'd show you guys what I see along the way, stuff like that. So it seems like up upon this hill is the grave. So I believe, according to the the website, it said that she is. No, it's got something in my eye, y'all. Cold for real. Really. I'll just jump on the camera. I don't even like do any like face cleaning thing. I brush my teeth, but yeah. But it said like she is, what is on my mouth? Okay, it says that she is like right before you get in there. She's after the right or something like that from Washington Boulevard. She should be under some palm trees. Like right after you get into the cemetery and then you make a right. She should be under three palm trees. So we'll see what we see. And I definitely don't want to do street parking. Kind of sketchy. So we're not going to be doing no street parking. It is downtown LA. Okay, so I believe right after you get in, somewhere over here, I think that's what they said. It's probably a lot of people that's buried here. A lot of famous people won't even remember lot of palm trees.
So, there's a lot of people out here. So, are we going to look at these instructions again? Because I don't think we read them right. Okay, it's according to the directions, it said she'd be under three palm trees. So, maybe that's one, two, three. It said that the palm trees would be close to each other. So, this kind of reminds me of that time when I went to go visit Emmett Till's grave and I was putting flowers. First, I couldn't even find his grave because it was very confusing for the, what was it confusing for? The map. But it says she's in section D. So is this section D? Section D, I don't know where I'm at. Maybe this is, I see a lot of like Asian. Maybe we in the wrong spot. Could be. This is the only place where I see three palm trees together. One, two, and three. Stay tuned. One moment, I gotta look for something. Okay, so I looked at a YouTube video of somebody else visiting here, and I think these are the three palm trees that they were talking about. And if I'm not mistaken, let's see. And here's Miss Hattie McDaniel. It's not really a place for me to leave any flowers. So, but this right here is fish. Miss Hattie McDaniel was born June 10th, 1895, and she died on October the 26th, 1952. She died of breast cancer. She is the first African American to win an Academy Award. She won as Best Actress in Supporting Role for a performance of Mammy in Gone with the Wind for 1939. Wow, that is history. I had to step away for a moment only because it's like I didn't want to like butcher anybody's credibility to what they've contributed and what they've done. I probably should do a little bit more research as to, you know, this is really what they accomplished, this is what they've done. And I didn't really do all of that. So I can tell you a couple things. Hattie McDaniel, she played roles in the movies from the 30s, 40s. I think she might did some movies in the 50s, but she always played maids. And of course, at that time, that's all blacks could get. Either they could be maids or servants or slaves in movies. Like blacks didn't have leading roles. Nothing like that when it came to television, films, movies, none of that. So Hattie McDaniel, she got her roles as Mammy. And you guys know Mammy, the from the plantation from the South. And she played in Gone with the Wind. She was a maid. Well, really a slave, and the slaves were freed, of course, and she played alongside others in the film. Like, I don't remember the actors or actresses. I know it really sucks. I haven't seen that movie in a while, but I am talking about Gone with the Wind. So maybe I'll, you know, put some stuff next to me, next to this video, like this. So yeah, it was, when I stood next to her grave, it was kind of like, it felt kind of surreal. Like, wow, I'm actually visiting her grave. Actually, you know, this was this person, she actually lived, you know? So yeah, something. It's something. I'm probably gonna jump way off topic, but I'm looking at these.
This grave. It's very interesting when you see pictures on people's graves. I don't know who these people are or anything like that, but it's kind of like, it makes you wonder, like, you know, what was their story? Who were they? All these had stories to tell. All these people that were here. Everybody has a story to tell. You know? Everybody has a story to tell.
Now, I'm not one for graveyards. I personally don't like graveyards. I personally don't like death. But I know one day it's going to happen to everybody. You know, so just one of them subjects that you got to be very, you know, prepared for. Even when you're not prepared for it. Because, you know, we all going to die one day. We all going to, you know. But yeah, it was something like, you know, visiting her grave and stuff like that, you know. But still makes me wonder, like, what are the rest of these people's stories? It's probably other people out here who are also, you know, well-known, famous, you know, just, they're gone. Like, time is very important. Time is very valuable, so. I think we're gonna go visit her old house. And I'm talking about Hattie McDaniel, because her house is in this area. Her old house that she bought. She'd throw parties. She'd invite a lot of the black actors and actresses or black entertainers at that time. She'd throw a party. I'm trying to figure out what else. I'm gonna walk back over there just for another second. So if you guys ever wanna visit this cemetery, it is located. Name of it is called Angeles Rosedale Cemetery. And it is kind of a little bit hard to explain where she is, but it's like when you come in through the entrance from Washington Street, she's like right here. And I read online, it said three palm trees. So these are actually the three palm trees right here. So we're actually right here. Huh. I didn't even think of that. So she's actually right here. And I also forgot to mention that in a lot of the films that, you know, she played in, she got a lot of backlash from the black community. Because at that time, blacks were, you know, doing well for themselves. Like, doing very well. So the black community was like, why is she playing a maid? Why is she still, you know, playing these roles like this? So don't quote me, but this is what I've heard. It's better to play a maid than be a maid and make $700 a week versus $7. And I didn't say that, but that's what I believe. That's what she said. So that was her response to the community. But why are you always playing a maid? You know, it's other stuff. At that time, it really wasn't a lot of stuff for blacks to play. When it came to movies and stuff like that, like. So, yeah. Guys, I just still can't believe I'm at the gravestone of Hattie McDaniel. This is history, like, this is history. Wow. it feels like a surreal type feeling. It's kind of like, I can't describe the feeling, but it's kind of like, it's very like a real person. This is the real person. You know, it's not like what you see on TV, blase, blase. This is the real deal. A lot of people remember Miss McDaniel for playing the uppity maid, whereas she wasn't afraid to be who she really was, standing up to them white folks, stuff like that. And I wonder else who is buried here, like famous people that gotta. Probably a lot of other people out here too. Probably a lot. So I just looked up who's all buried here in this cemetery that's like famous. It's a lot of people, like a lot of people. Interesting people that I found were, there was a lady named Louise. She was a serial killer. She died in the gas chamber. She's out here. And also Rasputin, you guys know Rasputin from Russia? His daughter is out here. So, interesting, right? Right. But let's go ahead and get on and go. We ain't in no rush to get here. Peace.
So guys, we are now off to view the former home of Hattie McDaniel. This was a mansion. At the time, I believe it had 17 rooms. Still has 17 rooms. And it should be coming up in just a little bit. I always like to look at the other homes that are around.
It's kind of like surreal going to these places. Like you see these places on YouTube all the time, and it's kind of really like surreal actually like seeing all this stuff. So let's see, I think you go this way. This kind of reminds me of that time when I went to Madam CJ Walker's Villa Noir. I went to her house, and it was at nighttime, and house was like, this kind of remind me of it a little bit. But it wasn't much that you can kind of see. Like, I really wanted to see the backyard. I can only see the front. Let's watch the road. Let's see, did we pass the house? I hope we didn't pass the house. Oh, it's coming up right here. All right, guys. So this home with the green roof was where Hattie McDaniel once lived at. Her rooms, well, her house had about 17 rooms, and Clark Gable would visit her, and they'd drink tea, like, I believe this was like every Sunday, so they would drink tea and stuff like that, and they talk about old times. If you guys know who Clark Gable is, check out Gone with the Wind. They were really good friends. Now, I'm not sure what kind of neighborhood this was, whether it was an all black, all white, maybe Hispanic type neighborhood. I don't even know what it was, but I do know with that house, there were other prestigious. There were other prestigious blacks that lived in the area, and they too had homes on the street. And this was like in the, I believe they call this area the Sugar Hill area. It's named after a place in Harlem during the Harlem Renaissance. So a lot of blacks move here. And I do know that they didn't want blacks living in this neighborhood. They would pretty much get the blacks kicked out. They would try to do that. And Hattie McDaniel, she wasn't having that. She got with a group of friends and a whole bunch of other people to pretty much do away with the discrimination of where you live at and all that stuff. So I believe that really opened up a lot of stuff in Los Angeles for people to like be able to move to, you know. So yeah, that was pretty much, you know, something dealing with that. You know, we still got that going on today. I don't care what nobody say. Like, it is still, you know, a lot of racial inequality. I'm actually going to loop around so I can see the house again, but it's a lot of racial inequality everywhere. You know, it's just crazy. That's the first AME church right there. I don't know much about it, but I believe that is a black church. I'm assuming it's a black church. But speaking of other ones, other people that lived in here, in this area, was Ethel Waters. If you don't know who Ethel Waters is, you guys got to check out your history. I believe she was a dancer, actress, singer. Don't quote me on this, but I think she rivaled with Josephine Baker. That's all I'm going to say. I don't know. Maybe she did. Maybe she didn't. Probably didn't. But, yeah. So I actually wanted to get out for a little bit, walk, maybe touch a little bit of history and stuff like that. But this is actually the house where Hattie McDaniel lived at. Now, somebody else lives here now, so it's not like we can go be like, oh, let's knock on the door and let's see. But you guys can see right there. Hold on. See? Wow. So she would come home every day. She'd go in, relax, have to be right back out. I'm assuming that's how that went. I don't know, but I do know the other people that stay here. I don't know who, but it is other people that stay here. But I believe it has like 17 rooms in this house. So, yeah. Now, how I found out about this place was YouTube. I'm not even gonna lie. I watch other people's YouTube videos, and I'll be like, oh, okay, I'm gonna visit that place too. Yada, yada, yada. So, that's how I found out about this place, was YouTube. And no, I'm not a historian. I just like making videos, and I felt like it was time for me to make a new video. Definitely was time to make a new video. Because I know y'all ain't seen me in a while, so why not make a new video? Okay, guys, so I'm at a different cemetery. This is the Hollywood Forever Cemetery, and this is where Hattie McDaniel wanted to be buried at.
In her will, she wrote, "I desire a white casket, a white shroud, white gardenias in my hair and in my hands, together with a white gardenia blanket and a pillow of red roses."
But at that time, when she died, there was still segregation. Blacks couldn't be buried with whites. White couldn't be buried with blacks. So therefore, that's why she's at the Angeles Cemetery. So they also decided to, when I say they, I mean the new owners, I believe in 1998, they looked into it and they were like, man, that's really messed up. Her dying wish was to be buried at the cemetery. So I guess he contacted the family to remove her from where she was, to bring her here to this cemetery. But the family was like, nah. So they gave her a little memorial, like a little plaque. It should be somewhere over here. I did see it. I'm not going to use Google this time to look. I'm going to see if I actually find it on my own. Although Google is easier, thanks to YouTube. But Now, this cemetery has a lot of famous people. I already know that it do.
I just know it do.
It does. It has a lot of famous people here. Like, I'm talking about famous from, like, the 1920s and all that stuff. It also has a mix of other people here, too. So, back to Hattie McDaniel. In 1959, they changed the integration. They changed that, and they decided to, you know, mix it up. So, I'm trying to find her plaque. If I can find her plaque, I gotta find her plaque. I have to find it, because that's like part of the video. We need that for footage. Okay, so this has nothing to do with the video that I'm currently making about Hattie McDaniel, but I had to stop and look at this. They fancy. They got some money. They had some money. I've never seen nothing like that. Okay. Maybe I don't know no Johnny Ramone. Y'all know Johnny Ramone? This must be where you come when you got you some money. Or this is where you come to be buried if you got money. Not funny, but funny. Okay, so, oh, here it is. Maybe this is the plaque. This is what we've been looking for Miss Hattie McDaniel. This is it, right here. So, this says, to honor her last wish, Hattie McDaniel. And this is exactly what we came here for, to look at. So, the owners, the new owners in the 1998 wanted to bring her here, have her buried, but the family was like, no, just leave her where she at. So this is the memorial that's dedicated to her, to honor her last wish. So now that we found that, now I guess we'll look up other people to see who else buried out here. You know, I normally don't like dealing with stuff like this, but this is a little different what I normally do. So it's also a nice day out today. It's really nice. Yeah. Okay, guys, so I did a little bit of research. So I found out Julie Garland has a mausoleum here. Charlie Chaplin is buried here. A few more other things. So I'm just doing research. This might turn to a different type of video. So I'm assuming this is for the actual dog from the movie. I'm assuming. Maybe, maybe not. It's like so crazy to actually be here inside one of these places. The final place where you come. I guess these are places where you can come. Famous old people here. But I'm gonna see if I can find some famous people. Stay tuned. So far, I've been walking around for a good little minute. I didn't really find anybody that was famous that I knew of. And no, that's not Charlie Chaplin that's here. It's his son. So we was thinking about Charlie Chaplin though, not his son. Yeah, but it's a peaceful day. Like, it's very peaceful. Like, come out here, clear your head, clear your thoughts. Cause they obviously don't have nothing to think about. Just like at the end, none of that stuff matters. The stuff that you're worrying about now and thinking about, money, bills, relationships, marriages, kids, job opportunities. At the end, none of that stuff matters. Good health, bad health, none of it matters. Nothing matters. None of it matters. Time is very valuable. Gotta cherish it. Alright, so I've been out here for quite a while. Basically just walking around. But we're back to the Toto statue. You know, the dog from the Wizard of Oz. So it says, we give you this new home 53 years later, as there is no place like home. Rest in peace, dear friend. Now, the story with that is, as I can recall and remember, the dog was originally buried under a freeway or something like that. And I believe nobody knew where it was for a while. Maybe they did, but he was under a freeway, buried. And then they moved him there. The story's starting to make sense now, because I remember hearing something about that, but I didn't really think about it until I started walking around and stuff. So, yeah, he was buried under the freeway. And then they moved him here, and it all makes sense. After 53 years later, we found your new home. So it's starting to make sense now. So that's what I do remember. But walking around and, seeing all this stuff made me think, this stuff we thinking about now don't matter. How much money you got, how much money you don't have, your dreams, your ambitions, your goals, people you've met, people you love, people you know, it don't matter once you get here. Doesn't matter anymore. I gotta correct myself. Actually, it does matter. A lot of people that I saw had graves that had a lot of flowers, a lot of mementos left on them because people actually remembered them. And I think it's very important to be leaving a legacy behind when you go and a story to tell. So actually, it does matter. One of the places where Hattie McDaniel actually stood. Now, this building is called Culver Studios. Now, Culver Studios has changed names over the decades. I believe in 1959, Desi Lou Studios from Desi Arnaz and Lucille Ball, I believe they once owned this too. Gone with the Wind, with that movie, they shot a lot of the interior shots like right in the inside. So now we are on our way to actually see what makes a star, and Hattie McDaniel had it to become a star.
Los Angeles, stay having traffic, like, especially around this time, they stay having traffic. I would love to do that, take like a tour bus of Hollywood. You know, I'll be able to learn so much more than what I'm projecting and what I'm giving out.
I haven't really told anybody this, but one day I want to be a really, really big star. And I'm here at the Hollywood Walk of Fame. It's right behind me. I think you can actually see some of the stars right here. These are people who are film, television, music. I might step on a star that I know and don't even notice it. Bette Midler, Carol Lombard, Bill Cosby, Alice Faye. It's a lot of well-known people. So I've always figured myself as drawn to the entertainment. Like, I'm supposed to be watched, supposed to be a star. I'm not even gonna say supposed to be, because I am a star. I'm one in the making. I'm waiting for my opportunity. I'm not waiting, no. I'm taking my opportunity. So let's go ahead and let's see what other stars we can find over here. So we are at the Grommet Chinese Theater. In the 1920s, this was the place to come. If you were having a movie premiere, this was the place to be. It'd be so many stars packed. Well, a lot of fans packed just to see this place like this. So you'd have your famous figures, like, I'm not even gonna mention, but you would see one right there in the background. And you just see where a whole bunch of names are immortalized forever. And these are stars from when Hollywood first started up to today. So it's really interesting. to actually see all of this. And you can kind of like feel how big their hands are, how big their feet are. I see a lot of people that I know, not personally know, but y'all get the point. I see a lot of people out here that I recognize with their names. And just to be able to put your feet where they stood at, for example, this is Robin Williams, and we'll use Robin Williams. He actually stood here in 1998. I don't want to put my foot in his shoes because those are shoes that are too big, but you know, you can kind of see how big his feet were. You can see how little his hands are or were. You know, he's not here anymore. So that's an example, Robin Williams. And moving on. So I'm just going to look around and kind of see who else I can see. And you know what? Me thinking about it, like, I've always wanted to be rich and famous, you know. Thinking about it, I really had to think, like, how do we become famous? Some people can become famous by accident and not even know it themselves. So, it's in the cards for us to be famous. Okay, so I just discovered a way to become famous is doing something that you love to do and become so good at it that it will attract people to you. And later, you know what? Money and stuff will come later. So, that's what I've come to the conclusion about being famous.
Rich too, but famous.
So we found the first star. It was a little hard to see, but it's actually like right here, Hattie McDaniel. So I almost overlooked it, but that was the first star. That star is in, it's for radio. So that's for Hattie McDaniel right there. All right, so I'm looking for Hattie McDaniel's next star. I think, so I've seen this one, you get them all confused sometimes when you're trying to find them. So I think I might have found it right here. It's actually right here. So this is Miss Hattie McDaniel's second star. So she has one in film. She also has one in radio. So that's really interesting. So thank you, Miss Hattie McDaniel. This is Lewis signing off. Peace. Oh, also, don't forget to like and subscribe. Come on, y'all, help me out. Nah, I'm just joking. Y'all be blessed. Bye.
Academy of Motion Picture Arts and Science, fellow members of the motion picture industry and honored guests, this is one of the happiest moments of my life. And I want to thank each one of you who had a part in selecting me for one of the awards. For your kindness, it has made me feel very, very humble. And I shall always hold it as a beacon for anything that I may be able to do in the future. I sincerely hope I shall always be a credit to my race and to the motion picture industry. My heart is too full to tell you just how I feel. And may I say thank you, and God bless you.